Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.5 RC, or Release Candidate. This is the final version of iOS 15.5 that was released to developers and soon to public beta testers, and as long as there's no additional issues, this will be the same version that's released to the public in a little while. Now this particular update is very large. Since we're switching from a beta to a final version, it's 5.27 gigabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was about 4 to 5 gigabytes on all the devices here. So it's a pretty big install. That's typical when you switch from a beta to a public version or from a public version back to a beta. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.5 RC, watchOS 8.6 RC, tvOS 15.5 RC, macOS 12.4 RC, as well as HomePodOS 15.5 RC. All of those are available now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then we'll go to about. As you can see, the build number is 19F77. This particular build has a few new features and changes in it, as well as bug fixes, and is not huge since we're getting closer to iOS 16. But the first thing that is not changed if you were on previous betas is the modem. There is no modem update in 15.5 RC. It's the same modem that we had with beta 4 and also beta 3 at version 1.61.00. Now, as far as new features and changes, well, the first thing has to do with Apple Wallet. It's pretty similar to what we had before. So if we go into Wallet, now you can see it says Apple Cash. So instead of having an Apple Pay Cash card, it now just says Apple Cash with the Apple symbol and the word cash after it. Then we also have buttons at the bottom that say request and send. So now you can request or send money from your Apple card. And this will also come to businesses later on where you'll be able to tap to pay doing that as well. But that doesn't seem to be active in the release candidate. To go along with this, Apple also updated messages. Now within messages, it says Apple Cash or has the Apple symbol with the word cash after it above your keyboard. So that's something they've updated within messages. Not a huge change, but something that matches what we have with Apple Wallet. The next thing has to do with Apple Podcasts, where they've included a new setting that allows you to limit episodes that are stored on your iPhone, but that are automatically downloaded. So that can take up a ton of storage, and you can find that in settings. So if you go into settings, go down to podcasts, under podcasts, you have automatically download. Now you have the option to go in here and change it to latest episode per show, 2, 3, 5, 10 episodes per show, or even the last 24 hours, 7 days, 14 days, 30 days, or all new episodes. So it says remove older automatic downloads by limiting how many are kept on this iPhone. The default setting will not affect shows with customized settings. So this is just a new settings option that they've added for this time around with 15.5. Now the weather app has a new button as well. So if we go into weather and you're on your local weather, so this is where I live, go to your local weather. You can tell that by the little arrow at the bottom. And if we scroll down, just keep scrolling down, you'll see it says report an issue. Prior to this, this was just text. Now we have a box. And if we tap on see more, we can now report an issue like we could before with some nice dialogues here where the overall condition is either sunny, cloudy, rain, sleet, snow. We can report the temperature, wind, air quality, and other conditions as well. So that's something they've updated to make that more prominent and more easy to recognize when you scroll down. Now they've also fixed an issue this time around where with home automations, you could have some issues where they were triggered by people arriving or leaving. And sometimes those would fail. So if you have a new home automation where maybe it unlocks your door as you arrive home, sometimes that might not work, or it may lock your door when you leave. That's been resolved in this update. So that was a problem before that they've fixed. On the iPad, they've made a change as well. On iPadOS 15.5 RC, one of the things they've changed, which we've had for a little while, is universal control. Under your settings, if you go to AirPlay and handoff, you'll see it says cursor and keyboard. Prior to this update, it said beta. It's no longer in beta. So cursor and keyboard has been finally fixed, meaning universal control, and it should work more seamlessly across your devices. So that's been updated and it no longer says beta. It said beta since its release to the public. Now it doesn't. Now, Apple has also added passkey technology on the iPhone for Safari. So passkey technology will allow you to more easily log into websites. This is something that we won't see just yet, but developers can add to different websites. So when you go to a website, so maybe we log into Apple, it would make it easier to log in. So that's something that the developer actually has to add within the code and should help in the future. So it will take a while to see this, but it's now available as far as passkey. Now, there's also new features for developers. So if you're a developer and you go into settings and you have developers settings turned on, there's some new settings to help developers with things such as throughput tests. So let me show you what that looks like. So you'll see I don't have developer settings yet. You need Xcode in order to enable that. Now, once you have Xcode on a Mac, you can run Xcode and then plug in your iPhone via Lightning, and a new developer option will show up under settings. So you'll see you have developer here. Tap on developer, and then if we scroll down, we have a new option for run throughput test. If we tap on this, we can start a test for ping packet loss, idle ping latency, download speed, or upload speed. So that's something that they've added with 15.5 that could be very useful for developers. Now, they've also added something else as far as support goes for DualSense adaptive trigger features. So that has to do with the PS5 controller, where it now can be enabled by developers to use that within games and use the DualSense adaptive triggers. Also, Apple has added the ability for developers to more easily enable SharePlay. So that's something that you could do before, but it's a little bit easier now, and we'll look more to what we have with Apple's app. So if I go into TV and then maybe I want to share an episode, we have the SharePlay button right there. Just makes it a little bit easier and nicer to be able to share your content with someone else. Now, they've also added additional support for developers as far as C++ 20 and C++ 23 features that have been added. So all of those things have been added according to Apple's notes. However, there's some known and resolved issues as well. There are still known issues within this update. So as far as the storage bug, they haven't mentioned that whatsoever. So if we go into settings, go to general, go to storage, it's the first time I'm opening it on the iPhone 11 just to see what it does. It loaded pretty quickly. Although when I tried this before on the 13 Pro Max, it was a little bit slower, but you'll see it loaded right away on the iPhone 11, and system data is showing 4.83 gigabytes. So it's within the realm of what it should be, usually within 10 to 20 gigabytes for system data. That can vary and should go down over time. But if you're having huge storage usage, let me know in the comments below. Also, there's no mention of whether or not they've fixed any issues with the music bug. So whether or not music was causing an issue in reducing your battery life because it was using additional CPU, they didn't mention that. And they didn't mention any issues as far as the phone getting warm. However, the phone is a little bit warm to touch as I've been filming this video, but it's not hot at all and wasn't even when it was installing the update. So for the most part, I believe those issues are resolved. But they did mention three issues that they've resolved, and one of them has to do with Matter accessories being resolved. So Matter is a new standard where you'll be able to use this on your iPhone. Matter supported accessories should now work at least somewhat, and also StoreKit issues have been resolved as well. So there were three issues, two with Matter and one StoreKit issue. Also, there's 10 known issues that you should be aware of also with this update. So one of those things has to again do with Matter. You can only pair up to 5 Matter accessories in a home right now. That's an issue. Also, the health app can have some issues from time to time where the health app can crash when you attempt to onboard the blood oxygen feature from within the app. So maybe you're trying to onboard that from here, use blood oxygen with your Apple Watch. Sometimes it can crash. They tell you to reboot the device or try again. Also, purchasing or downloading content from the iTunes Store and TV app might fail. Again, they say reboot the device to resolve it. And there's also additional issues with messages when it comes to conversation transcripts, where they won't scroll after you go into a quick look photo. Also, emergency SOS calls with 5 presses, although it said it's disabled for all users outside of India to fix an issue that caused the setting to unintentionally default for some. However, it looks like it's working for me in the US. So if I press this 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you'll see I can slide emergency SOS. So it looks like it's working now. Most of the major issues seem to be resolved in this update, but there could still be some odd bugs here and there. Now, Apple also released security updates with iOS 15.5, but they don't typically tell us what's new until the final public release. So we'll have to wait a few days or a week to know what that is. So you can see the last one shows iOS 15.4.1. So we'll have to wait until they update their security website to know exactly what they've updated. So we'll know when the final version comes out, and I'll let you know then. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.5 RC? And I would say there's no reason not to at this point, as it should be the final version released to the public. However, we have seen RC2 versions roll out again later on if there was additional issues reported by developers, but we don't have the feedback app, or at least I don't anymore, where it's removed with the RC since it's the final version. So if Apple doesn't change anything, this should be the full final version, and you definitely can install it. If you ever wanted to roll back to iOS 15.4.1, though, you would need a computer to do that. So just be aware, make sure you have a backup before you install the update. As far as the overall battery life, well, it will take a few days to know for sure, but as far as battery life for me, it's been getting me through the day without a problem. I really haven't had to pay attention to it much. Typically, I go to bed with about 50% left. So you'll see I'm currently at 81% today, and over the last 10 days, I had 3 hours and 32 minutes of screen on time, 8 hours and 59 minutes of screen off time, and used about 50% of my battery. Now, I should be able to get 10 to 14 hours of screen on time, but again, I go to bed with about 50% or more of my battery life remaining, so it really varies from device to device. I'm also still at 100% maximum battery capacity for battery health, so I charge this on the charger every night, all night long, and take it off on the morning and charge it in the car, so it seems to be doing okay that way. As far as performance seems to be okay. The oldest device here is the iPhone 8 Plus, and it seems to be nice and smooth, whether that be going into music, waiting for it to load here over Wi-Fi, we'll give it just a moment, but in general, it seems to be pretty smooth, and those that ran earlier betas of iOS 15.5 reported that it was very fast as well, so no issues here to report. Also, as far as the benchmarks go, I did run it on the 13 Pro Max, and we'll talk more about it in the follow-up video later this weekend, but let's take a look at the benchmarks. I ran it twice. The initial score was pretty low since I had just installed the update, but for single core, it scored 1,728 for single core, 4,747 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you can see here, again, I ran it twice. It was a little bit higher for multi-core the other day, but it was very close to similar for single core, maybe a few points lower, 4 points or so. So generally within 100, it's fine. It should perform just as you would expect, and I really see no difference. With everything from that to ProMotion or anything else with performance, it seems to be quite good. Now, as far as an iOS 15.4.2 release, I think we can completely forget about this at that point. I don't expect any sort of release as far as that goes, as Apple is pushing out 15.5 now that we have the release candidate. As far as when to expect that, well, typically I would expect it probably Monday or Tuesday of next week. That's usually what Apple does, so we could have it as soon as the 16th or 17th, and it would be out to everyone and for all devices. So that's really what I would expect with this. Then I would expect another beta this coming week as well, next week with 15.6 beta 1, moving on until June 6th with iOS 16 beta 1. So we'll have iOS 15 and iOS 16 betas all the way until September, where we have a final release of iOS 16 to the public, typically when we see iPhone 14 and more. So not a whole lot more as far as features with iOS 15, but I would expect iOS 16 to have some surprise features and more. Of course, we'll have to wait and see. So that's everything so far in iOS 15.5 RC. Of course, I'll have a full video of it when it releases to the public with any additional changes, and be sure to check back for that follow-up later this weekend. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.